Hello traders, and welcome to the last weekly trade ideas for this year before the market goes on holiday. So we have a week filled of major impact events on the calendar, and as usual I will guide you through all the major, including gold and crude oil. So while I roll the intro and disclaimer, hit that like button for me, and if you're new to the channel, do not forget to subscribe. See you there. So welcome back, guys. As I said, a lot of news event for the upcoming week to keep an eye at. I just marked the major impact event. We don't have the medium impact and the low impact event here, but as you see, there is lots and lots of news. We start the week directly on Monday with important events, especially the German flash manufacturing PMI, we have also for the sterling manufacturing PMI and services PMI, which is very important for the sterling. Hopefully now when the market is more certain about the politics of the UK, we will start to see these economic release gonna show some impact on the market. Manufacturing PMI from the US as well on Monday, monetary policy meeting minute for Aussie on Tuesday, business confidence for New Zealand, and so on. President Lagarde to speak again, CPI for both CAD and the sterling, and GDP quarter in quarter for New Zealand, Thursday employment change and unemployment rate for Aussie, monetary policy statement for the JAPI, not expecting a fireworks there. So then also Thursday, very important retail sales and the official bank rate vote for the sterling and the monetary policy summary. And on Friday, current account for the sterling and core retail sales for the CAD. As you see, lots of event. Very few for the dollar though. We for the most important for the dollar is the flash manufacturing PMI on Monday. So yeah, again, very important to keep an eye on those news events and have a plan for them each day you start your trading week. We'll start with the Dixie, which been in a bearish mode for a while now. So we had this first impulse, we had the correction of that, and another impulse that importantly broke previous level last week. So this previous key support got broken on during the Brexit, during the election in the UK. We've got the break, and on Friday we got a correction, or the market went back inside. So what we want to know here about the dollar, if this was to be a fake out and the dollar gonna hold back above this level, or it is just a correction for a continuation. So if we go down to the 4 hour time frame, we see that this time frame is still a bearish market. We still have lower lows and lower highs with this last previous lower low here, which tested a an important area down here, as you see, been acting many time as a good support level. So to keep an eye on that. And for me right now, for the dollar to be bullish again, it need to break back above 97.75 here at this level. So this level need to be broken for more upside for the dollar. Otherwise, what we have so far is still a possible retest and continuation to the downside for the dollar, especially that we broke strongly now below the 200 moving average. That been acting as nice dynamic support in the past. So we had this break, the market went back above and kept holding this as support. Same here, short-term break below it. But this time is the first time that we see the price deep down below the 200. Also, we've got a retest of that and continuation. That's why this signaling a possible continuation for the downside on the dollar. So keep an eye on where the market is testing right now. It could be going like this as well, retest of the monthly S2 and continue lower. Any break below this previous low will signal the continuation of a longer term bearish move on the dollar. Oil reached the key level of possible resistance at the 60. This level for me is a pretty important level. We've got a bit of a rejection last week at that area. Looking left, this level been acting as nice support previously, a trouble area here, as you see resistance here as well. So it is an important area. We had a fake out above this also previously to then see the market pushing back down. So 60 gonna be a pretty important level for oil. Keep an eye on that level. We do have a little bit of a divergence on the 4 hour time frame. A bearish divergence on this time frame is happening right now, and here where the price is testing at the moment going to be a pretty interesting area to look for a possible rejection or possible sell back down to the bottom of this channel. So we're still having oil inside this channel now, and this level where we see the price is testing at the moment is pretty important. Any double top or something like that at this area could signal a possible continuation to the downside, or at least to the bottom of this channel. So I'm looking to sell this level if we get the right the right trigger. Gold, if we go to the daily time frame, what we have on gold is still some kind of consolidation of a correction. So we had this impulse and we are now going sideways inside this channel, making what looks like as a possible correction or as a possible bearish flag. And if we break the lows, then we may look for continuation. So talking about flags, I've made I published a great article about how to trade flags on my site. The link is in the description below. You can go and read that after this video if you want to see how I trade the flags myself as well. I put a lot of tips and ideas over there. So talking about gold, we keep holding the same level as resistance. So as far as this area is not broken, it is still a sell level, and the bottom of this range is the key support. Even if we see a break of this flag or this channel, you need to keep an eye on this support level down here. It is very possible that you see something like this happening, similar to what we got last week on the Aussie, where we saw a break to the downside to then see the market pushing higher from the horizontal support. So even though if you would see a break of this flag, keep an eye on this level. This is actually the real support here and the most important level. So for now, keep an eye on this area. 1485 is a key resistance, and the 1450 is the key support on this market. So sell high, buy low, look for your triggers at the edge of this range until you have a break out of that. Okay. Euro, so for the euro, if we go to the daily time frame, there is one important level here, and that is the double top here. I've been talking about this for a while. This level is an important level, and for the euro to really start a longer term continuation move to the upside, it need to break above this level. So we need to see at least a daily close above this level. There was an attempt here on the after the election. We saw a really strong move to the upside, but when Friday tradings ended, the price had already pushed all the way back down below the key trend line we have here. It is a pretty important trend line below the 200 moving average once again, and below previous high. So there was no break and close above this level, which make it not broken, and which keep us thinking there is a possibility for maybe some more downside here before any continuation. So for our time frame, what happened here? Here we had the election night. So this is the election candle, the low here, the high here. So there was this spike to the upside to then halt at this level, making this correction before to start moving back down. So where the market is testing at the moment is a pretty nice and possible level of support. So keep an eye on that. If we look left, we see that this area been acting as nice support and resistance previously, as you see. So keep an eye on this level. It is an important area. Here we have support once again. This is a possible level that you may see a continuation from. So if the bulls to continue from this level, you need to see an impulse, strong impulse, correction, and possible continuation. Otherwise, this rejection could also signal, if we get some kind of flag like this, signal a possible continuation to the downside. Let's not forget that this is a very strong push to the downside. Look what a rejection candle here on the daily you had. After this spike, there is a lot of bulls that are trapped in this move as well. This is an important candle. And again, since we broke back below the trend line, if we see a slow correction like this, there is a possibility for one more leg to the downside. So keep an eye on this. Keep an eye on this level here looking left. This area here could also act as a possible resistance, giving you possibly a head and shoulder scenario before another leg to the downside. Okay. Sterling, same scenario here, pushed very strongly to the upside, but also even here there was no break and close above previous high to call it a broken level to look for a continuation. So the daily candle did close back below previous highs. If we look on the weekly time frame, we see that the price was back all the way to where the prices was during the Brexit referendum vote here, near the lows. But again, as I said, it's still a strong market with a bullish sentiment, but the structure level here is not broken yet, since there is no close above it. The price on the weekly is back above the 200 moving average, as you see, for the first time in for a while. The last time the price was above it was back in September 2014. It broke below it, retested, and since then there was no break and close above it. So this is the first time in a very long while that we see the weekly closing above the 200 moving average. And again, last week we had this very big spike, and I'm expecting possible correction now before any continuation or something like that to happen. So keep in mind now that you may see something like this happening, and a correction again. Now, any retest to this level could be an important area to look for a possible correction, or if you see the market making some kind of slow correction, there is a possibility for another retest down here. I still see 1.300 down here is a key support level to keep watching for this market. So if we look on the daily time frame, what we should be looking for is this correction and maybe a continuation from this level. This is the key level for the bulls to buy at from now on. USDJPY also did a strong push to the upside, reached the key level of resistance that I mentioned many times now. 109.80 is an important area. Looking left, we know that this level is a key level. There was an attempt on Friday to break above it, but it failed. So it was a retest of this level to then see the market pushing back down. I think there is possibly a continuation to a retest of this level, this broken range to be retested. So short-term trade next week after this impulse. Keep following this correction and look for one more leg to the downside toward the December NFP high here before maybe a continuation or a bounce to the upside. So look for this, sell any correction on UJ next week. New Zealand USD also kept pushing higher above the 200 moving average, strongly to the upside. I think the market objective here is at least to reach this level up here or previous high now after the break above this important area. But we want to see some kind of correction. So I'm still waiting on this market to make that correction. I'm not looking to sell this, but I'm looking to buy either this level or this level down here. So I'm looking to buy from here or from this area. So let me make that with some better tools. So you either buy this level down here or down here. That is what I'm looking for on this market. I think now after this breakout above this level, there will be a continuation, but I would want to wait for that correction. We have a very strong bearish divergence on the 4 hour, and that is signaling possible correction to the downside. USD CHF still a sideways market, as you see here. Nothing much is happening. We keep trading sideways. We had a break last week below this level, but the level of support was just below that. Another level of support looking left. This area been acting as good support area, and we should expect the market to make some bounces at such areas. As you see, this is a pretty old level that been acting as nice support and resistance many, many times. So right now, this is the key level for this market. As far as this holding as support, you may expect some kind of bounces from this level. Unless you see a break below it, then we're gonna look for next major support level, which is down here. So that is what you should be looking at for this market. Short term, keep an eye on this level, this area here, maybe a level of interest for the bears. If the price did a bounce to this area, keep looking for a possible bounce back down from that level. This is gonna be an important short-term level, and the important and the key support is now down here. If broken, look for this scenario to happen on USD CHF. USDCAD, I'm still expecting this market to continue to the downside. I'm still looking for a at least a retest toward this level on this market. Daily time frame, we see that there was a failure to make a new high here. As you see, we didn't make a new high. We have another lower high here that retested this neckline. And as soon as you see a break below this level on 1 hour or 4 hour time frame, you should be looking for a retest of this area at around the monthly S2 down here. Yeah, so if we look to the at the 4 hour time frame, we see it clearly that the market is sitting as support. In our trading room, we were looking for a retest toward this level first to then look for a sell to the downside. We didn't get that last week, so let's see if we're gonna see something like that happening next week. In any case, if you see this happening next week, try to sell it from this level, could be a good idea. Or if I see a break and close below this level, then I will start looking to sell the next retest toward monthly S2 on USD CAD. AUDUSD, also we were looking for continuation, but as you see, this market failed once again to break and close above the 200 moving average. It is a key trend line that got tested here. I'm talking about this trend line here that been confirmed now many times as an important level. It is hugging the 200 moving average as well. And on the daily time frame, last Friday there was an attempt to break higher, but it failed and reversed all the way back down, making a bearish engulfing candle. This is a strong signal for possible continuation to the downside. But before any continuation, I want you to keep an eye on this broken structure. This could act as support for possible continuation to the upside. Yeah, so if we measure this move with a Fibonacci retracement tool, we see that the 618 happened to be in this important kill zone. Since we had this broken structure here, these levels may now act as support, and we add to that the confluence of the 618. So keep an eye on this. If you get bullish evidence, there is a possibility for one more bounce to the upside. Otherwise, if that failed, there is no break, there is no bullish evidence, and you get a bull flag, a bearish flag like this, look for a possible move back down toward monthly pivot point. And the main reason I'm saying that possibility for the downside is this strong bearish engulfing candle we got on this market. So that could signal that we're going for one more time to the downside. But the longer term play here would be if we see a break above this level. That would be the key, the good and the long-term trade. If you see a break and close above this level, then it is really game over and it's time to look for a longer term move to the upside on this market. So yeah, that was the last market for today and for this week. I wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. There will be no weekly trade ideas next week, since as you see, it is all bank holiday and I will be back after the New Year. So the week after is also pretty slow, so around January the 5th I will make my first video for the year. So thanks a lot guys, and see you next year. Bye bye.